Thank you. Can I remind members of the COVID-related measures that are in place and that face coverings should be worn when moving around the Chamber and across the Holyrood campus? The final item of business is a members' business debate on motion 2730 in the name of Jackie Dunbar on My Breath is My Life. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put. I would ask those members who wish to speak in the debate to please press the request to speak buttons now or to enter R in the chat function. And I call on Jackie Dunbar to open the debate.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm very proud to bring this members' debate forward tonight. Can I first of all thank everyone for the cross-party support which has ensured the debate can take place this evening. In Scotland, around 368,000 people are being treated for having asthma. This includes over 72,000 children. This is not the total amount of folk suffering from asthma, as a lot of folk have this condition but are not diagnosed, as it is not an easy diagnosis to make. I myself went to the doctors about 9-10 years ago and was diagnosed as having borderline asthma, borderline COPD. At the time, they were unable to tell me which condition it was, and I was given 3 different inhalers, 2 to be taken once a day, 1 for asthma symptoms and 1 for COPD symptoms, and the blue inhaler that most people associate with asthma for as and when needed. I'm not alone in this kind of diagnosis. Many times it is trying to see what works for the individual. I'm not proud to say I was a smoker and quit over 2 years ago, and I'm very pleased to report that my lung capacity increased, and due to this, my medication strength was decreased, not something that happens if you have COPD. So I take it that I'm just borderline asthmatic now. Presiding Officer, respiratory conditions, including asthma, account for over a third of all acute hospital admissions and are also one of the most commonly presented conditions within primary care. I was pleased to see the Respiratory Care Action Plan launched by the Scottish Government last year, which focuses on ensuring across Scotland we have a consistent approach to the management of respiratory conditions in the 5 key priority areas: prevention, diagnosis, management, care and supporting self-management. Presiding Officer, in 2020 there was 113 asthma-related deaths in Scotland. 90% of those could have been prevented. 90% that could have been prevented. In the North East, the work of the Asthma and Allergy Foundation has been transformational in increasing awareness for people living with and caring for those with asthma. And my motion lays out all the fantastic work that has been achieved so far by them. Everyone here today will know someone with asthma, but would you know how to help support someone who was having an asthma attack? I didn't. In 2021, 49 people out of every 100,000 were hospitalised for asthma at least once that year. Scotland, like other UK countries, have a high prevalence of asthma compared to the rest of the world. Presiding Officer, an asthma attack is caused by the inflammation of the breathing tubes that carry air in and out of the lungs. Asthma makes these tubes highly sensitive so that they can temporarily narrow, and it is a condition that affects the airways and can affect people of all ages. Although it does often start in childhood, it can also develop for the first time in adults. The main symptoms of asthma can be wheezing, breathlessness, a tight chest and coughing. However, this does change from person to person, and it is currently incurable. But symptoms can be maintained through medicines, as I've already said, such as inhalers and steroids. The Breath is My Life project was launched in 2018 and has worked across Aberdeen and Aberdeenshire to provide asthma awareness and education within schools. The My Breath is My Life project, supported by National Lottery funding, delivered workshops to staff, students parents and carers to raise awareness of the condition and help people to become confident and capable of managing the illness within a school setting, and recognising not only the signs of an asthma attack, but also knowing how to deal with it. I was delighted to recently meet with the founders of the Asthma and Allergy Foundation and hear about their most recent national lottery funding, which will allow them to expand their workshops into the Greater Glasgow and Clyde Health Board, again delivering workshops for children and young people, but also exploring the transition into adult services and how young people can manage their condition in a range of different environments. Presiding Officer, I was advised that on average there are 2 children with asthma in every classroom. 2 children in every classroom in every school. That's a lot. And that is why I think it is so important that teachers and staff in every classroom are comfortable and confident in managing asthma in schools and having the knowledge of what to do if someone is having an asthma attack. For example, before meeting with the Asthma and Allergy Foundation, I was unaware that you should never put someone who is having an attack into the recovery position, as it constricts their airways further and they may stop breathing. I learned a valuable lesson from our hour-long meeting, and I am positive that the Foundation's expansion work will help to inform and educate many more people throughout Scotland. As many of you know in the Chamber, I donate my councillor salary to charities and good causes within my constituency of Aberdeen Donside, and I was delighted to be able to donate my December salary to the Foundation to help pay for further training for their staff and volunteers. Presiding Officer, I will finish off my contribution to this debate by thanking everyone who has supported the motion and to thank the members in advance who are speaking today. And last but not least, to try and be helpful by explaining what to do if you or someone near you is having an asthma attack. You should always advise the person to, one, sit up straight, try to keep calm, I know that's easier said than done. 2, take 1 puff of your inhaler, usually the blue one, every 30 to 60 seconds, up to 10 puffs. And 3, if you feel worse at any point or you don't feel better after 10 puffs, call 999 for an ambulance immediately. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Dunbar. And I now call Audrey Nicol to be followed by Tess White.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. I would like to congratulate my colleague and old friend, well, friend, no old friend, Jackie Dunbar, for bringing this motion forward. It's meant in the most respectful way. I know this is an initiative that she's been committed to as it's been developed locally in Aberdeen City and Aberdeenshire. And I refer members to my register of interests. I'm a councillor in Aberdeen City Council. And I thank the Asthma and Allergy Foundation for their helpful briefing ahead of this debate. I will shamefully admit that despite living in the North East, I had not crossed paths with the My Breath is My Life initiative until Jackie Dunbar brought forward this motion. The notion of a learning resource that delivered training to children and young people on how to cope with an asthma attack seemed so logical, and as Jackie Dunbar highlighted, the statistics speak for themselves. In Scotland, around 368,000 people live with asthma, around 72,000 of whom are children. And tragically, 2020 saw 113 asthma deaths. And I can't imagine the loss and sense of tragedy felt by families and friends affected by such a loss. Prevention plays a vital role in so many aspects of our lives, particularly our health and well-being, our daily multivitamin tablet, our free eye tests, and of course, getting jagged and boosted with the flu and COVID vaccines. We're so fortunate to be able to access a wide range of resources and educational opportunities to enhance our confidence and skills in responding to unforeseen events. Who remembers the recovery position from their first aid training or the FACT mnemonic in cases of suspected stroke? So it stands to reason, therefore, given the potentially serious consequences an asthma attack can have, the education on how to respond for those living with asthma, their carers, families and teachers could literally mean the difference between life and death. So the commitment of Martina Chukwuma Ezike in establishing the Asthma and Allergy Foundation and developing the My Breath is My Life resource is inspiring, turning her traumatic personal experience into an opportunity to educate and empower those living with asthma. And it was fantastic to learn the My Breath is My Life workshop has been delivered to almost 15,000 pupils, just under 600 teachers, PSAs, parents and others, teaching learners to understand asthma, identify symptoms and triggers, and importantly, how to manage their condition. A really, truly fantastic achievement. But of course, My Breath is My Life is not just about raising awareness. It's about supporting people to have a good life where they are in control of their asthma rather than their asthma controlling them. While currently a local initiative, My Breath is My Life will be making its own very valid contribution to ensuring children can stay in education, play sport, experience strong mental health, and further on in their lives, access skills development, education opportunities, and positive outcomes. In this regard, and in conclusion, Presiding Officer, I note the motion calls for My Breath is My Life to be made available nationally, and having spent many years in volunteering roles with children and young people, there is no doubt in my mind that a project such as this merits every consideration for wider rollout across Scotland, and I will do everything I can to support that effort going forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms Nicol. I now call Tess White to be followed by Rosa Grant.
Thank you. Deputy Presiding Officer, I'm delighted to speak in this debate today and pay tribute to Jackie Dunbar for bringing our attention to the work of asthma of the Asthma and Allergy Foundation. Asthma is one of the most prevalent health conditions in Aberdeenshire. It's also the most common lung condition in children, affecting around 1 in 11 children across the UK. As the members have stated before, 72,000 of those children live in Scotland. But while asthma is a widespread condition, its symptoms aren't always seen or understood by others. Difficulties breathing, wheezing, coughing, and tightness and pain in the chest are all commonly experienced by people with asthma. If these symptoms escalate, they can be very frightening. Fortunately, asthma can be managed effectively through the right treatment plan, but a diagnosis is nevertheless worrying for sufferers and their families. That's why the My Breath, My Life project is so important. It has helped children with asthma to better manage the condition, from understanding what triggers symptoms to how and when to use their inhalers. These may sound like small interventions, but the right inhaler technique is crucial for the medication to work effectively. The My Breath, My Life project has also helped to empower children, parents and teachers through targeted education, so they can better support their peers who have asthma symptoms. Too few people are aware that an asthma attack can come on suddenly and can be life-threatening, yet someone in the UK has an asthma attack every 10 seconds. When a child is having an asthma attack, it's not just their breathing that's affected. Young children might report a stomach ache. They might be unusually quiet. They might look pale. They might not be able to complete sentences. Knowing how to respond in a situation like this can save lives. 90% of deaths from asthma are preventable. Of course, the COVID-19 pandemic has brought respiratory illnesses into sharp focus, and I'd like to thank organisations such as Asthma UK for providing information and support to people with asthma during the coronavirus outbreak. During the pandemic, the reality for some children and young people with asthma is that wearing a mask for a prolonged period of time, such as at school, may be difficult. Asthma sufferers can experience anxiety and panic attacks as a result of face coverings, as they can amplify the feeling that you cannot access air. Removing them in classrooms can impact positively on the mental health of children who may already be feeling anxious wearing them. As the threat posed by COVID-19 recedes, I agree with Professor Devi Sridhar, who argued last week that children should be at the centre of a return to normality and the first to have measures in schools such as masks ease. Finally, Deputy Presiding Officer, as GP surgeries start to resume work that was deferred during the pandemic, I would urge patients who are due an asthma annual review to accept the invitation, even if they feel the condition is under control. The respiratory condition can be worrying for people of any age, but the work of the Asthma and Allergy Foundation has demonstrated how beneficial patient-centred education can be, and for that, I sincerely commend its staff and volunteers. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms White. I now call Rhoda Grant to be followed by Emma Harper, who will be the last speaker before I ask the Minister to respond. Ms Grant.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And can I too congratulate Jackie Dunbar on securing this really important debate. Asthma is a common complaint, and so common we often take very little heed of it. But it impacts just under 10% of the population. And while most people live with the condition, it can be fatal, taking the life of three people in the UK every day. And as Jackie Dunbar said, most of these deaths could have been prevented with better guidance and monitoring. Therefore, good management is crucial, and the motion shows how this can be done. The My Breath, My Life project helped young people, their parents and teachers to understand the conditions, its causes and its management. I grew up aware of asthma because my grandmother had it, and I remember her being having terrible attacks and being taken outside the house in the hope of helping her get her breath. It was frightening to watch as a young person, but it must have been terrifying for her. Therefore, even by simply raising awareness, this project has been very worthwhile. The pandemic has been very challenging for those with asthma. Not only the fear of catching COVID-19, but having lives disrupted much more than the general population, as they had to shield. And it also impacted on their families, who also had to take measures to protect them. Children, particularly, who have been told by their parents, have been told by those in authority for 2 years. So that's a huge portion of their life, that it is risky for them to be out and mixing with others, are much more likely to have their mental health impacted. And it will also be a lot more difficult for them to mix again with others with any confidence. People's careers will have been affected because they were required to shield. Not every job can be done remotely, meaning that some people have lost their jobs or even given them up due to requiring to shield. And we need to target support towards them to bring them back into the workforce safely. There's also the argument about masks and how it makes someone with breathing difficulties feel. And line that up against the benefits of wearing masks for the most vulnerable to COVID-19. It's a very difficult decision to take. The project also looks at triggers for asthma attacks, something that I think we would all benefit from understanding. Many can be triggered by atmospheric conditions and pollution, and we must cut pollution and emissions for the good of the planet to stop climate change. But we also need to do this to help people with issues with breathing, such as asthma and COPD. Therefore, this project should show the way on how we can build greater understanding in Scotland. Raising awareness of asthma allows us all to play our part in preventing it and supporting those who live with the condition every day.
Thank you, Ms Grant. And I now call Emma Harper.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As the co-convener of the Parliament's Lung Health Cross-Party Group, I'm still a registered nurse. I welcome the opportunity to speak in this important debate, and I thank my colleague, Jackie Dunbar, for securing it. Ms Dunbar has covered asthma and associated treatment extremely well. Actually, I've learned a lot here myself. It's important that we raise awareness of activities in our constituencies and regions by people and charities which focus on health issues. This work, which can ultimately save lives, is really important. I thank my colleague Jackie Dunbar, as I think she's highlighted again very well the important work of Asthma and Allergy Foundation and the My Breath is My Life project. The project has achieved outstanding success since its inception, delivering workshops to over 14,000 pupils and training over 700 teachers and support assistants on asthma. Presiding Officer, My Breath is My Life has excellently demonstrated that when education is provided to persons with asthma, their parents or carers, as well as teachers and classroom assistants and the wider public, better knowledge and understanding is achieved. The workshops carried out by the project included what asthma is, how to identify symptoms and triggers, education and learning, how to manage the condition, as well as how to manage breathing emergencies. When I watched the My Breath is My Life video on the asthmaandallergy.org website, the clinical specialist, Professor Stephen Turner, he said that education was extremely important and that education needed to be person-centred. Professor Turner said that the simple messaging needed to be provided, like the blue inhaler that you have been given is only to be taken when you have asthma symptoms, and the brown inhaler is to be taken all of the time. So just to add, the blue inhaler contains the rescue medication. Take it when asthma symptoms like wheeze or shortness of breath occur. It provides an immediate effect, an immediate relief. And the brown inhaler contains the prevention medication. You take that inhaler every day as prescribed, which can mean more than once a day. I agree with simple messaging. That is key. And many people don't realise that people can die from an asthma attack. I can't imagine the grief that is suffered by those who have lost loved ones to asthma. Presiding Officer, the British Lung Foundation has created a number of lung health champions in the Scottish Parliament. MSPs from across the chamber have taken on the role as a lung health champion to help raise awareness of many of the lung health conditions. I'm the asthma champion. I've learned a lot from many people, including Asthma UK, BLF and Dr. Tom Farden. Dr. Tom Farden is a respiratory and asthma consultant in NHS Tayside, and he is the lead in developing the Scottish Government's Respiratory Care Action Plan. I've had good advice and support from Damien Crombie, who until recently was the Government's Public Affairs Manager for AstraZeneca. He was the AstraZeneca Public Affairs Manager for Parliament, I should say, and he sponsored an asthma roundtable that I chaired prior to the pandemic. This has had particular focus on the importance of inhaler education and on the varying types of inhalers which can be used and how we can best support people, especially to engage with their specialists and the care and the review that they need. I also acknowledge the help from respiratory nurse consultant Dr. Phyllis Murphy. And yes, many of you will have heard me talk about her in the past because Phyllis is my big sister. Since the inception of the Lung Health Cross-Party Group, along with the great work which has been carried out by many of the people and organisations I've mentioned, great progress is being made in Scotland to improve treatment and outcomes for people with asthma. The Scottish Government are implementing the Respiratory Care Action Plan, an overarching strategy for health and social care services on respiratory conditions. The plan identifies key priorities and commitments to improve outcomes for people living with respiratory conditions in Scotland, including asthma. It will enable all health and social care to have a firm understanding of respiratory health and improve clinical and wellbeing outcomes for people in Scotland. So again, I want to welcome the work of My Life, My Breath project and the work that's been undertaken by the Scottish Government to improve asthma education. And again, thank Jackie Dunbar for bringing this debate to Chamber today. Thanks.
Thank you, Ms Harper. I now call on Minister Marie Todd to respond to the debate. Around 7 minutes, please, Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I want to thank Jackie Dunbar for lodging this important motion and welcome the opportunity to respond on behalf of the Government this afternoon. Asthma is a very common long-term lung condition affecting all ages. It's estimated that 368,000 people are affected by the condition in Scotland. That's 296,000 adults and 72,000 children, 7% of adults and 8% of children. Asthma symptoms can come and go, and some people might not have symptoms for weeks or months at a time. But asthma does usually need to be treated every day, even if the person is well, to lower the risk of symptoms and asthma attacks. We recognise the difficulties experienced by those living with a respiratory condition like asthma, and that's why we remain committed to ensuring that people living with asthma and other respiratory conditions receive the best possible care and treatment to enable them to live longer, healthier and independent lives. And we will do this through our priorities and our commitments set out in our first Respiratory Care Action Plan for Scotland, published in March 2021. My thanks go to all who offered invaluable contributions to the development of the plan. The plan sets out the key priority areas for driving improvement in the prevention, diagnosis, care, treatment and support for people living with a range of respiratory conditions such as asthma. A key part of this plan is ensuring early and accurate diagnosis of asthma. When people are given information about their condition early, they have more opportunity to explore self-management techniques and possibly avoid more intensive treatments. I want to thank the Asthma and Allergy Foundation for their work on the My Breath is My Life project, which included the delivery of asthma training and awareness workshop to children, to parents and to teachers right across Aberdeenshire to help people to understand asthma, to identify symptoms and triggers and to learn how to manage the condition. The Scottish Government is committed to providing the best quality tools and support for people living with all respiratory conditions in Scotland. We'll work in partnership with key stakeholders, including the third sector, to ensure that people with respiratory conditions have access to tools, resources and information that support them to manage their own condition. And we'll also ensure that people with lived experience of respiratory conditions are closely involved as we make progress against the commitments set out in the Respiratory Care Action Plan. And as clinical guidelines evolve, we'll also work with key partners, including NHS Education, NESS, to ensure the relevant training is made consistently available to a wider group of healthcare professionals, increasing understanding of asthma for all of those involved. Education is so incredibly important for this condition. It's really important to recognise the impact of COVID-19, as a number of people around the chamber have, on the delivery of care and treatment for people with asthma. It continues to be significant both in terms of access to respiratory services and also the longer-term impact of the pandemic on lung health could be generational. Respiratory services have continued throughout the pandemic, with hospital and community respiratory teams playing a key role in the COVID-19 response. Third sector organisations have also continued to provide invaluable support and information through this difficult time to our NHS, through to those living with respiratory conditions. For example, the Asthma and Allergies Foundation, My Breath is My Life project, has helped to support people to manage their asthma during this difficult time. The Scottish Respiratory Advisory Group has been established to support and oversee the implementation of the Respiratory Care Action Plan. Members include clinical experts from a range of respiratory conditions, including asthma, as well as the key stakeholders from across health and social care in the third sector. We are working to develop an implementation programme, and our one-year priorities include the transition from child to adult respiratory services. And we'll work with key partners to understand and improve the pathways for a successful transition. And alongside the Scottish Respiratory Advisory Group, we're working with the Alliance and have established a lived experience group to ensure that people living with a respiratory condition are involved in the design, the development and the rollout of service improvement projects. I want once again to thank Jackie Dunbar for lodging the motion for this important debate and to thank the Asthma and Allergy Foundation for the work that they do in supporting people living with conditions such as asthma. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting.